Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have another stack of pin mail to share with you. I know I've been doing a lot of pin mail videos lately, but honestly, I have been having the best luck with pin hunting and pin trading, so that is why I have so much mail to share with you. You might notice that I'm wearing my Judy Hopps Zootopia ears today, and that is because I'm pretty sure that almost every pin in this pile is a Zootopia pin. I think I've got a couple miscellaneous things, but lots of Zootopia. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 packages. So that's a lot, and I'm just gonna jump right into it. Before I open this first package, I do have one quick little disclaimer. Most of the mailers I have today, I have opened already because they were trades. And since I'm trading and I wanna make sure that everything happens efficiently and smoothly, I always open up my mail right away when I get it, just to make sure that nothing's missing and that everything worked out normal. I hope that makes sense. However, I haven't taken really any of these pins out of their bubble wrap. I haven't looked at any of them up close because I was saving that for you guys and for this video. So I would like to start with this package. This is a trade that I did with somebody from the UK. These are some pins that I had been looking for a long time. They are Zootopia pins. I see them come up on eBay from time to time. They're always really, really expensive on eBay. So I was thrilled to actually get a trade for these, and it ended up being like a really awesome, generous trade, and I'm super happy with what I'm pretty sure is in here. So I'm gonna open this up and take out what is inside. It's in a little plastic lunch bag, so I could kind of see the transparency through the bag, so I have a clue of what's in here. But let me open this up and show you what is in here. Ooh, it looks like there's some awesome extras too. So these are the three pins that I actually traded for. They are all from the theatrical release of Zootopia in the United Kingdom. However, Zootopia in the UK was actually called Zootropolis because I believe there is an actual zoo called Zootopia somewhere in Europe. So they had to change the name to Zootropolis. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's the story. But there are three pins in this set, and they were released along with the movie. Let me just show you them real quick. Here is the first one. It is, of course, Judy Hopps, who is my Disney hero. In case you haven't heard me say that before, I just love Officer Judy. Second is the Nick Wilde pin. He is another one of my all-time favorite Disney characters, super foxy guy. I feel like he's Robin Hood 2.0, if that makes sense. If you've watched the old Robin Hood animated film, he was pretty foxy, and I feel like this is a 21st century version of Robin Hood. Maybe that's super weird, but that's my take on it. And finally, there is this badge pin that says Zootropolis Police. I also just want to quickly show you the backing on these cards. It says, "This item is not a toy." So in case you were wondering, don't give these pointy, sharp objects to little kids. Thanks. I have been wanting to add this pin set to my Zootopia collection for quite a while, so thank you, Janine, for the trade. I absolutely love these. Very lucky to have found them. And I want to take a quick look at the extras she sent. First, I'm seeing this teeny, teeny, tiny little Nick Wilde Tsum Tsum figure. I gotta give you a close-up of this because it's like the size of a pea. So there is little Nick. Super, super cute. Next, she included this as an extra, which is a set of Zootropolis buttons, like badge-like buttons, so not enamel pins, but like buttons. Or badges. And here's a quick close-up of these buttons. I'm so excited that she included these because I've seen these on eBay and I've seen these in some people's collection, but I really had no idea where they came from or how I could get them, and I was lucky enough to receive these as a zap, as an extra, so thank you. This is super awesome. I cannot wait to put this on my Zootopia pin board. And the final extra she included is something I've never seen before. This is Zootopia, or I guess Zootropolis Festival wristbands. And I believe these are meant to be worn to like a music festival, which I think is hilarious. The Judy Hopps one says, "Throw your paws in the air." And the Nick Wilde one says, "The fox has arrived." And there's a closer look at the wristbands. They've got these little silver beads, and they say Zootropolis on the back. I seriously had no idea that these existed, but I am getting a kick out of this. Maybe I'll wear them when I'm done at Disney World in a couple of weeks. Probably not, but maybe. I might just keep them on the card as like a cool collectible because, like I said, I've never seen these, but super awesome to have them. So thank you again, Janine. I loved this package. Next, I am moving on to this mailer, which even though it is big, it only contains one pin. And this package actually came from the Hong Kong Disneyland Parks. Someone was kind enough to do a pickup of this for me. And honestly, as soon as I saw that this pin was going to be released, I was on it. I was hunting down someone to pick it up, and the person who ended up picking this up for me is Pin Trade Tracy from Instagram. I'll leave a little link to her Instagram down below in case you want to hit her up for some Hong Kong Disneyland merch or pins. She packaged this up really, really nicely. And this pin was released as part of the Pin Trading Carnival pin trading event set that came out in Hong Kong Disneyland. That was kind of a mouthful. I'm sure I said it wrong. And it actually was released in this set. It kind of came in a big, beautiful box. And I think there were a handful of different pins in it. So she included the original packaging, which is amazing. And then she just included the one pin that I had asked her for, which is, of course, the Zootopia pin. And here is a look at this pin. This pin, seriously, is one of my favorite pins of all time. It features Nick and Judy. They are wearing pin trading lanyards. They are eating some Disney snacks. There is a train in the background, and you may have heard me say in the past that I'm a little bit weirdly obsessed with Disney trains. They just give me all the feels. It says Hong Kong Disneyland on the bottom. It's got glitter embellishments, and I just kind of can't handle the gorgeousness of this pin. It also has a pin on pin design. It has two pin posts on the back, and it is limited edition of 800. This pin honestly might make the top 10 in my entire collection because it's so beautiful and it has so many things that I love about it. And Hong Kong Disneyland pins are always so gorgeous. So thank you, Tracy, for grabbing me this. I've used Tracy for pin pickups a number of times, and she often includes cute little extras like stickers. She also included a couple park maps. I really love this one because it's got Hero and Baymax from Big Hero 6. So thank you for the extras. Love your pickup service. And I love, love, love that pin. The next package I'm going to share with you, I actually received as a gift from a fellow YouTuber, Melissa. Melissa has a great channel called PixieDust and Peaches. I will link to her down below. She has an incredible, incredible pin collection, and she's just the sweetest lady ever. And she actually reached out to me because she had heard I had been looking for what is inside of here and that I'd missed it. And she wanted to pay forward a kindness that someone else had done for her. Now, honestly, anytime someone gives me anything, I kind of feel a little bit not worthy and almost a little bit guilty because I have so much Disney abundance in my life already, but I was really hoping to get my hands on this set. I missed it when it was released, and thank you, Melissa. I'm so excited to open this up. Oh, and I'm just noticing there's a really sweet little card inside, very pretty. I'm gonna open this up real quick. Such a pretty card. I'm gonna keep this note private just because I like to keep notes between friends private, but she has beautiful handwriting, and she did write, P.S. hope to see you at Toy Story Land opening, which I do think I'll be down in Disney World for Toy Story Land opening, so Melissa, I hope to meet you there. Okay, and here is what this sweet, generous soul sent me. I can't believe she just offered to give this to me. I'm like so surprised, but it is the January Mickey Memories pin set that was released by Shop Disney. I was not planning on collecting these. For some reason, I just couldn't bring myself to go out and buy this on the day it was released, and I have been kicking myself for it ever since. I don't plan to collect the entire 12-month series, but I did pick up the ones for March, which were gorgeous, by the way, and I was really regretting not getting this one because it's like the old school Steamboat Willie classic Mickey Mouse, which I love, and these are going on eBay for so much money, and I couldn't bring myself to purchase one, so I was just gonna sort of let it go. But I had mentioned it in a video, I think, and Melissa noticed, and she offered to send me this, and I am so grateful. And here is a closer look at this gorgeous limited release pin set. Like I said, I'm not gonna collect all 12 months because that's just too many pins for me. However, I'm gonna grab the months that I think are really beautiful and aesthetically pleasing, and I think this one with the Steamboat Willie theme is amazing. Thank you again, Melissa. That was so kind. I'm going to link to Melissa's channel, Pixie Dust and Peaches, down below. If you like Disney pins, you should definitely check her out. Her channel is awesome, and she's like the sweetest lady ever, and I cannot wait to meet her in June. All right, I have three more packages left, and these next two are from the same person. They're both from my friend Darlene out in California, and these are both trades. This one I actually haven't cut open yet, so I'm gonna go for it right now. And this is a Zootopia-related pin, as far as I know. Oh, here's a really sweet note. She says, I was so happy to pick this up for you. Well, me too. Thank you. I'm so grateful. This is actually a Pin Trader's Delight pin, or a PTD. And there was recently a pin flip that included a Zootopia PTD. And it is actually Finnick, the little fox, like the little badass fox with the big mouth. I was so excited when this came out at the Disney Studio Store Hollywood. And I was honestly kind of surprised that they didn't release a design like this earlier, because all of the Pin Trader Delight pins feature a Disney character holding a frozen treat, like an ice cream treat. And there are frozen treats in the movie Zootopia, so I thought it's only a matter of time before they release one featuring the Jumbo Pop. So here it is. I love these new backer cards. They're so pretty. And it features Finnick in his little elephant costume, and he is holding the enormous frozen Jumbo Pop, and it's getting a little bit melty around his feet. Super, super cute pin. And I will just quickly show you the back of this one. It features the ice cream cone print stamped on the back. That's how you know it's from Disney Studio Store Hollywood. And this one was a limited edition of 400. And it's a little bit easier to see it here without the backer card. So here's one more look. Super, super adorable pin. In the second package from Darlene, I have a few more pins that we did a trade for. It's kind of a long story how this trade has worked out, but it's been fun, and Darlene's been super awesome and helpful and just the coolest lady. But let me just quickly share these with you. None of these are Zootopia, but they're all kind of miscellaneous things that I'm excited to add to my personal pin collection. So this first one is a Winnie the Pooh and Friends character block pin. The character block series has been quite popular. It features a pin-on-pin design, and it's almost like Brady Bunch style looking characters. They're kind of all in different boxes looking toward each other. So you've got Eeyore, Pooh, and Piglet in color, and you've got my favorite Tigger, of course, up here on the side. You rarely see pins featuring Kanga and Roo, so it's awesome to see them. So many fun characters on this, and I am a really big fan of the Pooh Corner Gang, so I'm excited to have this in my collection. So that Pooh Corner block is an awesome one. I think it's like limited edition of 400 or so. And then we also traded for a couple like kind of little miscellaneous pins. And I'll get those out for you right now. So we have this pin, which is from the new Handbags Mystery Pin Set. This is the Alice pin, obviously. So it features an Alice-style handbag with a Cheshire Cat handle. I am a fan of Alice. I've been on a little bit of an Alice in Wonderland kick, so I'll be using this on a future pin board, probably for May, because, I don't know, I'm just on an Alice thing right now. And then there's this pin, which I love, and I wasn't actively looking for anything like this, but I saw this and I kind of just fell in love with it. It is obviously a Jungle Cruise pin. It features Mickey as a Jungle Cruise skipper. Pluto is riding along as well. I'm a huge fan of Jungle Cruise, Adventureland, basically anything Adventureland just makes my day. I don't have a lot of other information about this pin. It's from the year 2006. I'm going to look it up on pinpix.com and see if it came out in a set or what the deal is, but I'm really happy to have it. I had never seen it before, and I am glad that this is in my collection. Thank you, Darlene, as always, for a wonderful trade and just basically being so, so nice to me. And finally, the last package in this video features a pin set that I have been looking for forever. This pin set has been driving me freaking crazy because I was in the parks when it was released. For whatever reason, I did not buy it. I should have bought it because it sold out, I think, relatively quickly, and I've been hunting for this ever since. People are selling it on eBay for ridiculous amounts of money. I managed to find this on Instagram to purchase for a somewhat reasonable price. I'm glad I got it in time for the current Flower and Garden Festival because it is a Flower and Garden pin set, but it also features my favorite character from Zootopia. So let me take this out. It's packaged in a little Walt Disney World bag. Oh my gosh, I cannot believe I finally have this in my possession. This is a 2017 Flower and Garden Festival pin set. It is limited edition of 500. And when I show you a close-up of this, you are going to see why I wanted it so bad. There are four pins in this set. They each feature a different character. So we have Figment as a tomato, Orange Bird with an orange, Judy Hopps with her carrot. Oh my gosh, this is why I wanted the pin set. And also Stitch drinking out of a pineapple, which is one of the cutest Stitch pins I feel like I've seen released in a long time. So this, I think, is a highly sought after set. It's a low limited edition. The retail price was like $55, so it wasn't cheap to begin with. And now if you try to find it on eBay, if you're lucky enough to find it on eBay, it's usually going for like $100 more than that. It's pretty crazy. It's pretty hard to find. So I'm very grateful that I was able to purchase this at a price that was somewhat reasonable, and this has been kind of a grail pin that I've been hunting down for a while. I honestly never thought I would get my hands on this one. I never thought the word completist would enter my vocabulary as a pin collector because I think that's just a lot of pressure to put on yourself to be a completist about any specific character or type of collection, but I really do have my heart set on becoming a Judy Hopps completist. So I've been hunting high and low. I've been working my butt off to find Judy pins, and there's actually not that many that I'm missing. There's a handful that I'm missing, and so I feel like someday the title of Judy Hopps completist might actually be within my grasp. This was a big piece of that puzzle, and I'm like so, so happy. Okay, so that is it for this edition of opening Disney pin mail and freaking out with DisneyKittee. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite pin from this pin mail opening was. Honestly, I can't choose one. They were all my favorites for very different reasons. I loved the trades that I did, and Melissa, again, thank you for the gift. It's been so, so nice to see how nice the people in this Disney community are, and I hope I can repay the favor to you guys and to many other people. There's like not enough hours in the today for me to send out all the mail and presents that I want to. Oh, and by the way, I've been meaning to say this. If you've sent me a present to my P.O. box, I have it. I am just so, so backed up on mail right now. It is coming. I will open it in a video. I will send you a thank you note. I am in the weeds on my mail right now, you guys. So I appreciate everyone that sent me something. If you're worried that you sent me something and I didn't receive it, please feel free to send me a message and make sure. But honestly, I have my whole second bedroom just like full of packages to open, and I'm so grateful, but I am also really behind and life has been really busy. So I just want to throw that out there in case you're wondering if I got it or if I'm going to show it. I am, I swear, I promise. Okay, anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a magical day. There are more Disney related videos coming your way in the very near future, and until then, I will see you real soon. Bye, guys!